Hi guys, my name is Shachi and welcome to this video. So today I'm in Georgetown, Penang, and if you are planning a trip to Penang, you would have definitely heard of Georgetown, which is sort of the center and the cultural capital of Penang. Now Georgetown is this eclectic mix of street art, heritage houses, amazing food, and lots of sightseeing and shopping. So this video is going to be about Georgetown. Now if you're planning to come here, since there's so much to do, it makes some sense to plan out your day and really plan what you're going to do here. In this video, I'm going to show you around my day exploring Georgetown and tell you about all the things that you can do here. Keep on watching. The agenda is to first start with the street art, that's the street murals. Now these are scattered all over Georgetown and we are just walking around searching for them. And there's the first one. The story behind these murals is that it's actually quite recent. It's just about 10 years old. And once Georgetown became a UNESCO heritage site, the government actually commissioned these murals to make this heritage town even more interesting, and most of these have been done by foreign artists. So it's a good idea to have a map with you to find all the murals, and we found one physical map right here near the jetty, and this has a list of how many? I think about 10-12 murals, and we've covered just one.
Around 20 murals.
Around 20 murals. So let's go. Ready? One hack to find murals is to look for people. So any corner you see groups of people standing with a map, looking at the map and, you know, trying to figure out, that's your clue to know that there is a mural somewhere around there. So to explore Georgetown and to find all these murals, you can either walk, which is what we are doing. You can rent those tricycles that you just saw. They take you around for about 10 to 15 minutes and they even stop at the mural so that you can take the pictures. Another option is to rent a bicycle. So there are all these bicycle rentals and you can also rent a bike and just go around the entire place. If you're really confused about finding the murals and you don't know where to start, a good landmark could be a Armenian street. Especially if you're getting to Georgetown by a cab, then put the location as Armenian street. This is a street where I'm standing on and this is where you'll find the maximum number of murals. Right now we are in the oldest part of Georgetown and this is the part wherein you basically have a church, a mosque, a Chinese temple and a Hindu temple all together in one road. And starting at the beginning of the road is the church behind me. This is called the St. George Church. And right now it's closed, we're not going inside. But we're going to continue further down the road. Penang is a mishmash of different cultures. There's Hindu, Islam, the Malay culture, the Chinese culture.
Imagine.
street is actually called the Harmony Street, and after seeing the church, the Chinese temple, the Hindu temple, the last stop is the mosque. This is called the Capital Kelling Mosque, and this is one of the main landmarks in Georgetown. So we've spent about, I think, 2 hours walking around Georgetown and exploring all the murals. It's currently about 2 p.m. and we're going to stop for lunch. So if you're a vegetarian, it might be a little difficult to find a vegetarian place in Georgetown, but there are quite there are few places. One such place is the one behind me. It's called the Healthy Leaf, and now we're going to go in and grab some lunch. Lunch, the next thing that we're going to do is check out the upside down museum right behind me. Now, Penang is a place which has a lot of interactive museums. You have a 3D museum, you have a magic show museum, you also have a gold museum, and of course you have the upside down museum. So today we have decided to check out this upside down museum, and now we're going to go in and do that. Let's go. If you're roaming around Georgetown, don't feel restricted to just stick to the streets where there are murals. Feel free to wander along any of these lanes. So this is one such tiny lane we found, where there are these beautiful houses which are built along the Perinakan architecture. And all along Georgetown, you'll find many such lanes. So feel free to just get lost a little bit and explore whichever part you feel like. Next, we are at the Chiu Jetty. So in Penang, there is a big establishment of Chinese families. These are more than 100 years old. And these were the families who were the original tradespeople who came here to Penang. And they settled along the coast. So you have 6 such jetties, and each jetty belongs to one clan of the Chinese family. And first, we're going to check out the Chiu Jetty. Now, these are basically water villages. People still live here. And part of these villages have been converted into restaurants, into cafes, and to souvenir shops. So this is a nice place to just stroll around, spend about 30 to 40 minutes. But make sure that you come here in the evening towards the sunset, because it's really beautiful to observe the sunset from these jetties. So let's go and check out the Chiu Jetty. So these are the houses. People still live here, and these are basically water villages. So for nightlife in Georgetown, then the one place that you need to come is the Love Lane, and that's the lane behind me. So this lane is basically a series of cafes which have outdoor seating and music. And also this is open till really late in the night. I'm told it's open till about 1 a.m., 2 a.m. So if you're looking for nightlife or a place to just hang out after an entire day of searching for murals, then this is the place you need to come.